Hello, everyone. I have felt led to offer some midweek check-ins during this season of Advent, so here I am. How are you? Really? How are you? It's been rough for some of us, hasn't it? And yet, here we are. And this is a season of hope. That's why I have this candle representing hope. I tried to find one that wasn't all sort of dirty around it, and you can see sort of the soot coming off of it, but then I thought, you know what, this does represent hope. Because all around us, things seem a little off, maybe a little ugly, and yet within us, for those of us who have put our faith in Jesus Christ, hope still remains. This past Sunday, some of the boys in the congregation led us in the lighting of our Advent candle, the candle of hope. And they said this, that Jesus called himself the light of the world. And at Advent, which means coming or arrival, and during Advent we wait for the coming of Christ, the coming back of Christ to come and make all things right and new again. And we remember the coming of Christ as a baby in Bethlehem. At Advent, we light candles to remind ourselves of the light of hope that he, Jesus, brought into a world filled with the darkness of sin. Hope is looking forward to something wonderful. It is expecting something good to happen. It is light in the darkness. This candle represents hope. When Jesus came, he brought hope for people lost in sin. And in the book of Isaiah in the Old Testament, chapter 9, verse 2, the people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. I think hope is sort of hard to wrestle up sometimes, isn't it? But if you have put your faith in Jesus, then though that hope may be hard to feel, it is there. Because the Spirit of the living God lives within you. And that means that hope lives within you. In Romans chapter 8, I'm going to put this candle down. In Romans chapter 8, I just want to read a few verses. This is from the New Living Translation. Yet what we suffer now is nothing compared to the glory that he will reveal to us later. For all creation is waiting eagerly for that future day when God will reveal who his children really are. Against its will, all creation was subjected to God's curse. This is the time of the fall. But with eager hope, the creation looks forward to the day when it will join God's children in glorious freedom from death and decay. For we know that all creation has been groaning as in the pains of childbirth right up to the present time. Don't you feel like you're groaning just inside? You're just groaning sometimes. We believers also groan, even though we have the Holy Spirit within us as a foretaste of future glory. For we long for our bodies to be released from sin and suffering. Amen? Whew! We too wait with eager hope for the day when God will give us our full rights as his adopted children, including the new bodies that he has promised us. We were given this hope when we were saved. If we already have something, we don't need to hope for it. But if we look forward to something we don't yet have, we must wait patiently and confidently. and the Holy Spirit helps us in our weakness. For example, we don't know what God wants us to pray for, but the Holy Spirit prays for us with groanings that cannot be expressed in words. And the Father, who knows all hearts, knows what the Spirit is saying, for the Spirit pleads for us believers in harmony with God's own will. Whew, there's a lot to unpack in there, but it means for us as believers, hope is within us. The Holy Spirit has put hope within us. Hope that one day these days of sin and suffering will be over and we will be granted the fullness of our adoption as God's children. And in these days, when sometimes we don't even know how to pray, just help me, Lord. The Holy Spirit knows the depth of what we need and prays for us with groans that don't even have words attached to them. I just love thinking about that. That even when I don't even know what to pray, the Holy Spirit knows what to pray for me. And then the Father understands what the Spirit is praying and according to his own will. The Lord always hears us when we pray. So if you're feeling like hope is waning a little bit in your life right now, take heart. Take heart. I mean, maybe you have pulled back a little bit from your relationship with the Lord. Maybe you have pulled back from the community of faith. I encourage you to press in. Press in. Keep saying those prayers. Just help me. Help me. And I believe that you will sense the Father's nearness as you pause long enough to call out, help me, but still pause to sense his nearness. As we finish today, I want to read, this is from, it's called An Advent Journey of Hope by Louis Giglio. And he says this: it's easy to bail on God at the first sign of trouble. It's easy to fret, worry, make new plans, and settle for shortcuts. But there's another way, the quiet way of rest and trust. During this Advent journey, keep making the confident decision to choose God's way. Say no to anything and everything that promises you peace, the kind of peace that only God can give. Guard your heart from any voice that offers a quick fix. Instead, say, Jesus, I want to wait on you. Jesus, I want to wait on you. The best things in life take time, and the payoff of doing things God's way is always better. But the enemy is crafty and determined to deceive us, shouting that the wait we endure is a sign that God is not good. Stay the course. Don't give in. Choose the path that leads to life and hang on to the hope that Jesus outshines everything else that glitters in this world. Let's pray. Father God, creator of the stars of night, help us to wait for you. You came to us when we were lost and couldn't find our way to you. As we journey during Advent, reveal to us the things that we've counted on to fill our heart apart from you. And give us the grace to lay those things down. We will wait for you. We will trust in you. We will put our hope once again in you, in your goodness, and in all of the promises that you have made. Thank you, Lord. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Take care, everybody. And if you have need of any kind, please don't hesitate to reach out. Amen.